Now, let's move towards the next slide. What do you mean by Docker machines? We have understood about our Docker like Compose. Let's move towards our Docker machines. What our Docker machines actually tells us? This machine management for a container, it is a centric world. So this machine has to be there. It is a centralized thing. Without machine, you cannot run your Docker, like any of the files and all these things. That's the reason it creates your Docker host on a system. When you are going to install your Docker, automatically your Docker machines is going to be installed. And as it is a cloud service provider, so you are going to use the registry from your Docker machines. And as it is a cloud service, for all the data centers, you can use your Docker machines. And it creates the server. It installs the Dockers and it configures with your Docker clients. So whenever you are going to install the Dockers, and if you want to send pass any of the message from your Docker clients to Docker servers, that time you can do all these things by utilizing your Docker machines. It belongs to many container tools. There are many tools actually which will be helping for you for finding out how easily you can deploy your things by using these Docker machines. One tool definitely we are going to use as we will be using your Docker commands and all, Docker Compose, Docker Swarms, VirtualBox, all these things we are going to be used. Most of the things we are going to cover it up. So now, one more thing is, this Docker machine, it can be loaded in your Ubuntu system also, in your Linux environment, anywhere. And generally, small, Docker machines will be holding the container servers, such as like your Jenkins and all these things. I will be showing you how to create these Docker machines inside your Ubuntu system or in your Windows or any of your open source and all these things we are going to see. So what is the pros we are getting for this? It is easy Docker host management. It will be having the host for its own and it is very easy to manage. So now going forward to our next slide, what do you mean by this Docker engine? So now, this Docker engine is your open source containerization technology for building the applications. As we know that our Docker is not going to help out by using the hypervisor softwares. Instead of hypervisor softwares, we are going to use our containerization technology. So it will be an open source system and it will be easy to deploy all our programs. And it also acts like your client server applications. And this Docker engine, it is a bunch of things where application has to deploy in the production side. And as we have seen already, orchestration components, actually, I'll show you in my next slide that one. In my orchestration platforms in components, how the Swarm nodes is using this, running through these containers in a very simplified way. I'll show you in my next slide. Let's follow up with this slide now. It supports the workflow of building, shipping, and running all this methodology. Now it creates a server-side daemon process with images, containers, and storage volumes. It creates all this in your server side, how this has to be secured with your images, containers, and your storage volumes. Now, as we have seen till now, all these terminologies, now I will just join the terminology to understand in a better way. That is, what do you mean by Docker platform? If I will join with my Docker engine and my Docker hub, see, Docker engine is your containerization. It is having the containerization technology. Docker Hub will be your cloud-based repository system. So both the things, if I will be joining up, I'm going to get my Docker platforms. So now what do you mean by like this Docker daemon? What is the work of your Docker daemon? This is totally consists of your building the image, running the containers, how to manage the containers, all these things in a detailed way, it is going to be work out with your Docker daemons. Now next one is your Docker image, how it is going to be, the Docker files with the necessary dependencies. If any library functions, if any dependencies are there, put together, all together, it will be calling as your Docker image. Now let's move towards our architecture. Yes, I was talking about the orchestration capabilities, the components. As you can see, the architecture of your Docker engine, you will have one great idea about this. Yeah, currently, let me check my chat box. Hi, ma'am. What are the security issues in Docker? Why we will call it as a security issues? It is not at all a security. There will not be any security issues because as I have cleared in the very way, as it is having less security issues and all these things, we are going to work out with our Dockers, because our actually cloud repository only we are saving all the images. So it is itself having the security things. So whenever we are pulling or pushing the images from our Docker hub, we are not going to think about the security. It will be, I will be telling you now itself, the orchestration capabilities. You can see my next block diagram where I am going to use my certificate authority, which will be your cryptographic key exchange. It will be a cryptographic identity, which will be authenticated with the key nodes and all these things. Here itself, it is providing us the network issues. Hope I have cleared your doubts. Thank you so much. Coming back to my slide, here you can see that it is orchestration capabilities. So now in this, in my orchestration components, these Dockers will run with our Swarm nodes. So now here, the manager will be there, the workers will be there. So all these people have to work with our TLS and your certificate authority. So now, this TLS is nothing but, as we know, this is a transport layer security, and it provides a very secure socket layers. And before, actually, we were using the SSL, that is known as your secure socket layers, and it was having the versions SSL 2.0, SSL 3.0. Once it was there, it was having some vulnerabilities problem, and from there we have come up with our TLS, which is known as your transport layer security, in all the layers, in all your networking layers, it is providing us the security, and it is also known as your secure socket. So in each case of your secure layers, it is providing you the sockets. And it is having the, currently we are using the version 1.3, and it has been started off with our TLS 1.0, TLS 1.1, then we were with the TLS 1.2. Currently we are using here in our orchestration components, TLS 1.3. So now, and in this certificate authority, it is providing us the cryptographic identity, and which will be helpful for this manager and worker for the authentication and for any of the key exchange nodes and all these things. Into these channels, we are going to use all these things. And this, the next block diagram, you can see that is a load balancing. And as I told you that our one of the server, which is Nginx, it used actually on our load balancing. So whatever the servers we are using for this Docker Compose on these Docker machines, everything will be on behalf of your load balancing. The next one will be your service discovery. It has to find out the discoveries and all these regarding your services and all. So once it will be settled down, all these things, it has to check it out before running this container. We have to check it out with all our networking, volumes and plugins. Then we have to go for our container running things and all. So whenever we are going to deal with all these things in one machine, in one engine, so that time we are going to deal with all these components, and we are going to get as a single service, as I told you, the Docker Compose did. Now let's move towards the next slide. Here you can see that how this manager and worker works in between, the relationship and all. The detailed description about this manager and worker you will be finding out in your Docker Swarm session. Here I'll just give you one brief description about this manager and worker. And here you can see that this manager node is dealing with TLS and the certificate authority, as I have already discussed about the TLS and certificate authority. And the worker will be dealing with only the TLS. So here, whatever will be having, if you have any security layers, if you want to provide and all these things, directly the manager will be dealing with the workers, and each manager will be interconnected with each other. The workers also will be interconnected with each other. So in this way, if one manager is having any issue with the worker, they have to solve within that container itself. As it is a dependent node, still then it will not create any problem for your one more manager, because all these things will be in your different containers and all these things.